keep the secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is your man, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you, all right? Now listen, before we get into this video, you know exactly what you need to do, man. Make sure you drop a like, all right? Drop a big like, because Uncle Demi done brought the Rare Build series back for y'all. Y'all been begging for it. I'm like, all right, man, I tried to throw it under the bus. I was like, yo, man, we moving on to other things, but y'all just keep spamming me, and I'm like, all right, bet, man. I got some more rare builds in the bag I can throw out to y'all. So I said, man, let me go ahead and clean out the closet real quick. So if you want me to continue this series, get this video to 1,500 likes. I'm repeat, if this video don't have 1,500 likes, don't be asking me for no more rare builds. Get this one to 1,500 likes. So if you want to see the rare build series come back, 1,500 likes for this video, all right? Now, 60K soon in June, mission complete, right? 60K soon in June, mission complete. Obviously, we're now sitting at 61,215 nephews and nieces. We will probably most likely finish a little bit over 62K, right? So that's 12,000 new nephews and nieces this month. So you know we gotta go dog stupid in July. Y'all been giving me a lot of good sayings for July, so pray for me. I don't even know right now. I still don't know what I'ma say. For July, it's very hard to find something that rhymes with July, but we're gonna figure it out, all right? Trust me, we'll figure it out of how we can get some type of saying for July. And you know what? We might switch it up too after a day or two. I'm like, you know what? That don't even sound right, all right? So just work with me. But regardless, I'm 100% grateful and I'm excited for what we have accomplished thus far. So please continue to show support for your favorite old head, Uncle Demi, and this Rare Build movement. As you know, I am the founding father. I birthed these Rare Build movement, man. So if you see anybody else on YouTube with these channels, man, I peep them. I peep them from a distance, you know, eating off the crumbs. But, you know, I peep them. Ain't no one popping like me. But, hey, man, it is what it is. We all know who started this. We all know who had the Rare Builds first, who started this movement, man. So I don't even have to address it no more. But, anyway, let's get into this video, all right? So we're gonna make a playmaking shot creator at the center position. So you remember when I brought out that point center build, all right? The point center build a while ago. This is somewhere to that same type of play, right? It's gonna be different, okay? But regardless, we're gonna go with the pure playmaking pie chart. You could make it out of the playmaking and the shooting, you could. But this right here is actually a little better because the ball handling is better. And that's the only thing that really matters to me. I'm just trying to speed boost off rip. So of course, you know, we're trying to speed boost off rip. Throw everything else away, what I've been talking about, like having a balanced pie chart and strength and all that. Nah, we just need to dribble, right? So what we're gonna do here is that we're gonna get this to 66 and we're gonna max this out, all right? And then we're gonna max out your mid-range, three-point shot, your free throws, and then we're gonna go ahead and get this to 61. All right, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our pass accuracy to 72, and then we're gonna get our ball handling, and then we're gonna max out our post moves, all right? Then we're gonna go interior defense, perimeter quickness, lateral quickness, blocks, offensive rebounds, defensive rebounds, and then you can go right there, and that will give you 12 on your steals. You have 15 to work with. Now, with that 15, I say go ahead and put it on your standing dunk. I know it doesn't make sense, but it makes sense in a way because you want to at least have something as much as you can for your standing dunks. Standing dunks is very important. So you want to go ahead and get that standing dunk if you want to, okay? If you want to throw it on steals or if you want to throw it on your post fade, you can. But most builds you're not going to post fade on. And also if you do put on post fade, then you have to max your wingspan out a little bit because you will lose the name. You'll be an offensive oriented five. And you want to be a play shot at the center position. So, I mean, without getting long-winded, worst come to worst, probably just be to put on standing dunk or your steal, right? Just to keep it a stack with you. That's going to be the best bet. But but you only have one finishing, but you're not really worrying about that because it's a play shot. You're mostly just going to be ISOing up, trying to shoot threes anyway, all right? So it is what it is. You do have 11 shooting badges. You do have 23 playmaking, and you have 12 defensive and rebounding upgrades. Now, the cool thing is that this is solid for my non-legends, but if you are a legend, you're looking at 11, 21, 33, and 22. That's pretty toxic, okay? Actually, not pretty toxic. That is toxic, regardless, okay? So that is an option that you have if you are a legend. This is a pretty good build, especially at this point in time in the game where you're just trying to get creative. This is something that you can really use, right? Now, for me, I'm going burly. I just like the way that the broad shoulders look. I'm going 6'9". I'm going to lower my weight all the way down to 190. And then I'm going to lower my wingspan all the way down to 81. So what I'm basically trying to do is just being just like how I made Duke Dennis's stretch playmaker build, right? You know, Duke and I, we collabed on that. And obviously, you know, hey, man, things started popping off with this stretch playmaking way, all right? We also have this build right here. And there's also another one, a three-level playmaker that I'm going to be bringing out to y'all soon, too. So a three-level playmaker that can ISO. So there's some pretty good things coming down the pipeline of this rare build series. If you want to get to 1,500 likes, then I will go ahead and bring those to y'all, right? But as you can tell, you'll have a 90 speed, right? Which is very important, along with a 79 ball handle. So of course you'll be able to speed boost with a 90 speed, with a 79 ball handle. You're gonna be A-okay with there, so you don't have to worry about that. Your mid-range will be an 85. Your three-point shot will be a 78. This is gonna be pretty cheese, to be honest with you, okay? Now, your block, your defense and is gonna be pretty solid also. But remember, you're a guard, so this is a guard. Not look at this, and someone in the comment section will be like, yo, man, this dude can't guard centers. Yes, because it's supposed to be, this is a guard. He is gonna be playing the guard position. So when you play with this build, then you make sure that the other players you have are gonna be centers and power forwards that do not have playmaking. Hence, that's what you would do. Like, this build would be great if you had a playmaker shot creator and then you had, like, maybe, you know, two glass cleaning lockdowns or a paint beast or something like that, to where you will be able to be at the point guard position or at the two. So, you know, you can do that too. You know what I mean? It just depends your play style. But here you have to go with the playmaking takeover. That will just obviously help you with getting the animations as far as dropping people, because unfortunately, when you are a power forward or a center, you do not get certain badges, and I'm pretty sure you know what badges we're talking about. But here you have it, a playmaking shot creator at the center position, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna test this build out real quick, give him the 99. Of course, I'm gonna get y'all out of here. So let's give him the 99 real quick. Whenever my drunk loads, all right, here we go. With this one badge right here, just go ahead and go with contact finisher. Not much you want to do there. All right, now here you go. So what you want to do here, quick draw, base 38, gold, and gold. These right here are the most important ones, all right? Hot zone hunter and range extender, those are the most important. For me, the next important badge will be green machine. So once you start greening, then all of a sudden that will just continue to allow you to get in that wider green release window. So we're at green window where you would be able to consistently hit more greens. So this is the lineup I would go with. Of course, if you are a legend, then I would say I'll go with volume shooter. And then I would go with dead eye and then some corner specialist shoots. I love that. I love corner specialists. All right. And then here on the playmaking, this is where you have dream shake, tight handles, space creator. You got to have your space creator, handles for days, quick first step. These are the most important ones, right? You do have three left over. I say go ahead and put that on bell out. You can also change dimer along with floor general. It just depends on what your preference is. This build, you have to abuse space creator because you do not have ankle breaker. So space creator is where you're gonna do. So you're gonna have to do a lot of hop steps to get those animations until you get playmaking takeover. Then of course, once you get playmaking takeover, that's when the fun begins, because you would then be able to hopefully get some ankles and drop some people on the ground, and that's what's really fun about the playmaking take, right? So last but not least, here again, you're going to be a guard, so you want to go with clamps. Oops, you do want to go with intimidator. You want to get rim protector, you want to get chase down, you want to get rebound chase on silver, and where are you? And then interceptor, okay? So remember, this build is not expected to be playing on-ball defense, so you're going to be in the corner, but you do want clamps, you do want intimidator. You do want to be able to get the rebounds because the rebounds is maxed out. Rim protector and chase down are just from the animations. And that's pretty much what you would need. Like, there's not really much that you could go different, other than the fact is, like I said, if you are a legend, then things have changed a little bit, because that does give you additional 10. So you can go gold here, so that would be 1, 2, 3, that make that gold, 4, 5, that make that gold, pogo 6, 6, 7, 8, and then maybe get that on gold too, that's 9, and then get one extra badge, maybe put that on, I don't know, maybe off-ball pass, maybe get off-ball pass on silver. Okay, so I know some of y'all legends love me talking about that. There's nothing here for a legend. Maybe you can just go ahead and get this, max out floor general. That'd be 4, that'd be 1, that'd be 5. Then maybe tight handles, right? So that's 9. And then you have one more, maybe needle threader. Of course, here, if you have your 10 badges as a legend, then of course you want to go max this out. So that's 1, 2. Giant Slayer. No, that's just 6-9. You'll need that. So 1, 2. Then you'll go Silly Finisher. 3, 4, 5. Acrobat. 6, 7, 8. Consistent. 9, 10 on silver. All right. So, I mean, like I said, you do have some options. And again, like I tell you all the time, guys, this is your build. So don't necessarily take all this and feel like, you know, what I'm saying is like what you have to go by. It's your build. Make it any way you want to. You do not have a lot of wiggle room with the attributes. I will repeat that. You do not have a lot of wiggle room when it comes to the actual attributes of the play shot build, but you have a tons of wiggle room on the badges of what you want to do with your build and based upon your play style, right? But other than that, my nephews and nieces, this is your man, Uncle Demi, right? I hope you enjoyed this video. Please make sure you like up this video and subscribe. Also, check me out on Twitch as I do stream daily on Twitch. Sometimes I say every other day, just depends. But also, hey man, listen, let's go ahead and continue and to finish out this month really strong. Let's hit the 62K and let's start making that big push for hopefully 75,000 nephews and nieces in July. Other than that, this is your man, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon, another banger, man. You know, when I say I'll be back soon, another banger, you know exactly what day I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.